Muchas gracias a todos, un placer, buenos días, un placer estar acá y ser parte del coloquio IDEA. Hoy tengo el placer de conversar con Paul Polman. Paul es un líder transformacional, visionario, un embajador del medio ambiente. Y hoy nos invita a reflexionar sobre nuestro rol como líderes, sobre la responsabilidad que tenemos en generar un futuro más sustentable y equitativo, con un impacto positivo en el desempeño de nuestros negocios. I will turn to English now. Hello, Paul. Nice to meet you. Welcome to Argentina, at least virtually.
Bienvenido a Argentina, aunque sea virtualmente. Gracias por estar con nosotros.
Ha visitado muchas veces de COVID, no hemos visitado los últimos dos años, pero tengo mucho respeto por la gente y con una situación no tan fácil, tienen siempre el optimismo y el gana de mejorar su país y yo espero que esta conferencia va a ayudar también en este sentido. So, gracias por la oportunidad, pero vamos a hacer el charla en inglés. Es mejor para transferir las ideas claves en esta discusión.
Thank you, Paul. And as I said, you really transform what you did in Unilever and being a CEO for almost a decade. But I know that the audience would like to know what you have been doing since then.
Could you please share your thoughts? Desde entonces, ¿podría compartir sus ideas? Sí, gracias Florencia por la oportunidad. Lo que descubrí es que fui durante 10 años el CEO de Unilever y vi que después de 10 años la tarea de CEO tenía sus limitaciones. Había muchas cosas para hacer en la sociedad y muchas cosas de las que son responsables los CEOs y que es difícil que cumplan. ¿Cómo se hace una agricultura sostenible? Por ejemplo, la soja. ¿Cómo se detiene la deforestación? ¿Cómo se puede limitar los plásticos en el océano? ¿Cómo hacemos para que los gobiernos pasen a un futuro sostenible? Es muy importante todo esto, aunque las empresas tienen un mayor nivel de confianza que los gobiernos. No podemos alcanzar los objetivos por nosotros solos. Entonces, hay que tener los objetivos de desarrollo sostenible y los objetivos que yo ayudé a desarrollar y preguntarse, ¿cómo podemos acelerar la implementación de los ODS, especialmente sobre desigualdad y el cambio climático? Con el COVID retrocedimos como 15 a 20 años con estos objetivos. Estamos totalmente atrasados en cambio climático y desigualdad. El COVID hizo que 50 millones de personas más fueran pobres y las economías no están progresando de la manera adecuada. Entonces, ¿cómo podemos hacer que las empresas se reúnan para tener cambios transformativos más importantes? Entonces, si nosotros podemos hacer que muchos CEOs masa crítica en la cadena de valor, podemos crear cambios que alcancen al sistema. Por ejemplo, 60 empresas se reunieron en la industria de la indumentaria, que es una industria muy destructiva por muchos motivos, desde el punto de vista de la biodiversidad, de los plásticos en el océano y emisiones de carbono. Estas empresas están pasando a energía verde, que pasan a algodón, por ejemplo, regenerado, y transforman los mercados de las prácticas destructivas en el cultivo. Están implementando el Acuerdo de París y están utilizando plásticos de uso único. Y también empresas de alimentos, estamos very important for your country as being one of the major exporters of agriculture.
We're looking at private equity and trying to change private equity by bringing cultivos, in
better impact measures.
And the reason that that is gaining traction
tiene que
is because
tener
when you have 20 to 25% of an industry together, civil society wants to join, governments are getting interested, and you can drive the needed systems changes that are needed. Interestingly, bringing the CEOs together as well makes them collectively more courageous.
Valientes,
still many CEOs are worried. Can I do sustainability, energy, and profit? Can purpose and profit live next to each other? And increasingly, by being together, we learn from each other, we become more courageous and set the bar higher to accelerate the changes that we need. In the spare time that I've had, I've also spent time on leadership development. I chair the SITE Business School at Oxford. This is one of the best business schools and part of the Prime movement, the 1,000 universities, to change the way we teach people. Many of the MBA programs is still, may I say, Milton Friedman on steroids. So how can we get the best leadership that we need? And then finally, I advise the UK government, the French government, the Indonesian government, for example, on things around the G20 or G7, COP26, the climate summit that is going to be held in Glasgow, but also the COP15 on biodiversity or the UN Food Systems Summit, to ensure that we get more ambition out of the governments, because ultimately, we need to work together to address these challenges. And just being less bad or being neutral in our impact is not good enough anymore. We have to become net positive, and that's one of the reasons I found some time during COVID and all the other activities to also write a book.
I agree, Paul, and as you said, it's critical to be change agents in this process. And you know that the colloquio idea, the main claim of the colloquio idea, is let's achieve a sustainable country, sustainable Argentina. And we all know that there are many companies that are moving forward to be less bad, as you said in your book, to be more
malos,
good, and,
como
and
dice
to, in a way
libro,
to reduce the damage they created.
And
how do you see the business in the future? What does the better business look like?
Considering
your
futuro,
book, in your book, as you said before, your focus is mainly in net positive. How we can be more net positive companies?
Ser una compañía neto positiva.
Yeah, well, it's very simple. Our overshoot day this year was July 29th, which is the day that we use up more resources than the world can replenish. In other words, every day after that, we're stealing from future generations. We have lost 68% of our species, mammals, birds, reptiles, in the last 5 decades. We've cut half of the world's rainforests.
Y así proteger, por ejemplo, las especies, como decía, los bosques, los árboles.
Just being in the CSR space, important as it may be,
también
which really deals with less
responsabilidad,
some
la
of these
responsabilidad corporativa, tener en cuenta las externalidades negativas, eso ya
less
no alcanza, no alcanza con concentrarse solo en eso.
If I was a murderer and killed 10 people,
y
and now
entonces,
I'm only killing 5
people, ¿qué tenemos que hacer?
Am I a better murderer? I don't think so.
No creo que alcance con proteger solamente a la madre naturaleza. En los próximos 10 años necesitamos enfocarnos en estas medidas. Y esto sí es posible, algo que sea mejor para el mundo.
A 16% increase.
Estamos proyectando un 60% de aumento.
CSR is not enough.
Entiendo que la CSR no alcanza la responsabilidad social corporativa. Estoy hablando. Entonces, hay que ser sostenible. Pero sostenible, ¿qué tiene que ver? Si no solo alcanza con no ser malo, o no alcanza quizás con solo ser bueno, claramente, esto no alcanza. Tenemos que empezar a pensar de otra forma. Sí, tenemos que
net positive. And that is difficult to do.
Difícil,
and the book describes in very simple terms
a veces se puede
what we need to do there. First, in the personal
hacer.
Transformation,
primero,
and how to get courage as a leader, because it ultimately starts at the top.
Empezamos
but then also,
arriba,
how do we implement
la
it in our companies,
hay que
in our value
en
chain,
empresas. y a nivel de la industria. En última instancia, ¿qué podemos hacer? Hay que ser más positivos.
Very practical examples on how to
ejemplos
do it.
Muy prácticos.
The what for us is actually less
de hecho,
of interest. I think most people are convinced
muchos
that these
están
changes need to be made,
que
but
se
they struggle
que hacer
with the
el
how.
Cambio.
And then we don't shy away from
no hay que
some of the challenges of CEO compensation,
que
money
que ver
and
compensación,
politics, corruption,
dinero la
trade
política,
associations
la
saying different things.
¿Qué ocurre en las asociaciones, en las organizaciones? Algunos de los otros retos que afrontan las organizaciones. ¿Cómo podemos llegar a crear un movimiento para avanzar? Es una oportunidad tremenda. Y no tenemos que comprometer estos objetivos. Tenemos que seguir adelante. Hay que hacerlo en forma sostenible. Sí, y el seno de esto es la sostenibilidad, que las empresas, las compañías tengan mejores resultados en este tema.
Y todas las industrias
también hay empresas.
So it's important that we all go into this direction.
Hay que olvidarse que tenemos que seguir por este camino,
but also to ensure that we continue to run
successful businesses.
What do we call that positive?
These are businesses
that take the ownership, if you want to, of all impacts and consequences of them being there, intended or not.
It
was a very simple question. Is the world better off because you're in it or not? These are businesses that operate for the long-term benefit of business and society, that create a positive return for
un retorno positivo para todas las partes interesadas. Hay que pensar en las generaciones futuras y el valor que se le da a los accionistas, no solo en cuanto a las utilidades y los resultados, como resultado de lo que hacen, y no como una mirada miope.
They are actively involved in the broader changes that society needs. So you start to see increasingly net positive companies showing up. Microsoft making a commitment to recuperate carbon emissions since they started the company in 1975.
Walmart
and others making commitments to go to regenerative agriculture.
Other companies making commitments to move
minimum wages
up
well beyond the standards
that the government set.
Google now coming out with
Google,
programs
por ejemplo, con
that help consumers make more sustainable choices, be it on investments or be it on things of what products they want to buy or etc. So increasingly we see companies moving to this net positive area, and these companies are not only more resilient, have better managed the COVID crisis if you want to, but are also better positioned for this future that we all aspire to have.
Sorry, we have the airplanes, so that's why the noise. So sorry about it.
Nos disculpamos por el ruido de los aviones que están sobrevolando.
We talk about and you mentioned in your book as well and in every talk
que mencionas en tu libro y en toda charla, que es importante llevar los valores a la acción, uno de los pilares principales de este coloquio en nuestra agenda. También dijiste que es clave que los líderes sean humildes, que sean bravos, valientes. Entonces hablamos de líderes valientes. Si pensamos en las megatendencias que vemos, los retos enormes que vemos en el redimensionamiento, es la desigualdad, los problemas que causa el cambio climático. ¿Qué necesitamos? Necesitamos más líderes valientes en las organizaciones, ¿no? Para efectivizar el cambio.
Florencia, as I said, we are moving. I think many people are aware of the challenges. There are not many CEOs who want more climate change or unemployment or people going to bed hungry. Yet collectively, we are not getting the answers that we need. Look at the challenges in your part of the world, but that is a micro reflection of what we deal with in other parts of the world. What is very clear is that politics is not in fine shape. In many countries, we have nationalists, xenophobics, populists. Our multilateral institutions are not functioning quite the way we want. So the argument that we have in the book really is in the interest of business.
interés de las empresas. Hay que estar más activos para garantizar que la sociedad pueda funcionar. No se puede defender ningún caso de pobreza, por ejemplo. Uno no puede ser un mero testigo o espectador de todo esto. Así que, como nunca tuvimos estas advertencias como las que tenemos ahora respecto del futuro, también es absolutamente importante que las personas, cada uno, avancen esto para defender estos objetivos, para y así necesitamos también la comunidad empresarial. Esto necesita valentía para hacerlo. Se necesita valentía para fijar metas que sabemos que va a haber que alcanzar. Y aunque no tengamos todas las respuestas, y también poder forjar estas alianzas, y a veces incómoda que uno tiene que abrazar. Hay distintos conceptos. Hay que poner todo esto en el corazón. Y como ya lo hicimos durante la COVID, sobre todo si pensamos en las empresas, los líderes que han demostrado realmente lo que se necesita. Y se tienen que actuar con un alto nivel de humanidad, de compasión, de sentido de propósito. Los cambios no son fáciles. Hay escépticos, por supuesto, muchos obstáculos que hay que superar.
These leaders think multigenerational.
Tienen que pensar en forma multigeneracional.
And above all, can also work.
Y sobre todo, hay que trabajar en alianzas.
So these are the type of leaders that have actually done very well. I think in your approach, where you look for transformative partnerships with business, government, and civil society, also in Argentina, is the only way to overcome some of these big challenges that you have, the need for job creation, or attacking the inequalities that you have, at the same time dealing with the pandemic.
You know,
these are so many changes that are coming at the same time.
Que se necesitan y la velocidad del cambio tecnológico es vertiginoso,
que frankly needs all of us. And I'm actually glad, and that's why I'm here, that IDEA plays such a broad role in not only driving the values that are needed into the Argentinian business community, but that you can also foster these broader partnerships and create these multiplier effects that we need.
And
Paul, how do you feel about that? You mentioned that the partnerships, to have partnerships is key to be a net positive company and to articulate
neto positiva. ¿Y cómo se siente acerca de este esfuerzo colectivo que tenemos que hacer para empezar una nueva tendencia? ¿Es optimista o pesimista? ¿Estamos movilizándonos
con suficiente velocidad? No, la verdad que no.
Pero estamos avanzando en la dirección adecuada. Y hemos hecho más progreso de lo que nos demos cuenta.
During COVID, when COVID came regretfully, which, by the way, is a good reminder that we cannot have healthy people on an unhealthy planet. It's also a good reminder of what the consequences are of destruction of biodiversity. These are zoonotic diseases. The surprise was really not COVID, because we've had SARS, Zika, Ebola, Asian flu, and many of the other things. The surprise was actually our inability to work together as governments of this world to do something about it. And fortunately, we saw local communities coming together, businesses stepping up their activities that resulted in getting a vaccine in a short period of time. But this was a warning sign for all of us, and not the finest moment. Everybody thought a year and a half ago when I would be doing these talks, all the businesses must be cutting back on ESG or on sustainability. They must just focus on profit alone again and cutting costs. Nothing could be farther from the truth. I chair the UN Global Compact for the Secretary General. We had 14,000 members before COVID. We have 17,000 members now. We had about 1,000 companies making commitments, of the biggest companies, to be net zero by 2050. We now have the commitment of 3,000. And even on the government level, including Argentina, by the way, we had only 21 countries before COVID, making a commitment to be net zero
que se by 2050, hacer,
which is the Paris Agreement.
Now we have 131 countries.
So civil society is moving, people are speaking out, businesses are starting to move, the financial market sees these opportunities, increasingly governments are moving. So if we now can foster these broader partnerships and work together to make these structural changes, then by all means we can get there. And by the way, my message is very simple. It is the biggest opportunity we have.
If you look at COVID, regretfully,
we have spent in Europe and the U.S. more or less $17 trillion to save lives and livelihoods, and we're not out of the woods at all. $17 trillion. The IMF estimates that we have lost $26 trillion in the global economy in GDP terms. That is infinitely higher than the money we have to spend to implement the Sustainable Development Goals, which is about $3 to $5 trillion a year. The cost of inaction has now become significantly higher than the cost of action, which also means that businesses that understand that can see this as an enormous opportunity, and the smart businesses seize that. The businesses that want to continue to deny that, I think increasingly put themselves at risk and will end up in the graveyard of dinosaurs.
You have a large number of business leaders here in the room and following you on YouTube.
Would you like to give any advice or what would be your call to action to all of us?
Well, you have many smart business leaders that set the tone and have always done also in Argentina. You have some incredible businesses. You know how to be resilient in that environment. You know how to deal with unexpected surprises in that environment, and yet you have businesses that have been around for decades, if not for centuries, because you can navigate these choppy waters. But increasingly, with the pace of change picking up, it offers threats for the ones that don't adapt, but enormous opportunities for the ones that adapt. And my message is really three. It starts with being courageous and being the inspirational leaders that these organizations deserve, leaders that take responsibility of their total impact into society, leaders that set targets that they know are needed, leaders that work with these partnerships. So that's my first message. The second message is really about the enormous opportunity we have here. This is anybody who understands this and seizes this and prepares him or herself well for the future will be rewarded. Unilever had a 300% shareholder return over the 10 years, a 19% return on invested capital over those 10 years, despite doing 64 acquisitions. This is our biggest business opportunity, and increasingly, companies that are making this change, the Teslas, the Orsteds, the Nestes, and many others, are getting significant valuations as well from the financial market. And my final message is basically the need to work in partnerships. And I know it's difficult also in your country sometimes to work in these partnerships, and when you have these big changes moving to the left and to the right, it's not always easy, but we can only solve the broader challenges that we have if we all come together. And even if it's not your government you've chosen for, or if it's not the company that you would ideally like to work with, this is the time that we rise to the challenge. It's only with that combined strengths that we can really solve the issues at a different level than that they are created, and that obligation to do that is now. Otherwise, the consequences will be significantly worse than what we already have to deal with now. So you're well placed. I've always admired you for your ability to adapt, your agility, your resilience. And again, I know for sure that you will turn this
que ustedes van a convertir a esto en una de sus mayores oportunidades y ser una fuerza importante para América Latina y el mundo al crear un mundo sostenible, equitativo en el futuro, y que es lo que todos queremos. Y es por eso que es uno de los motivos por el cual yo soy optimista. Primero, porque siempre subestimamos la velocidad de la tecnología.
And it makes me optimistic to see how many things we have already within our reach available today that could provide us with these solutions to these challenges. The second reason is the young are really speaking up. They don't want to work for companies anymore that are irresponsible. They are demanding the changes of their governments. They're moving forward with creative solutions that we should embrace. And the third reason is really the cost of inaction being greater than the cost of action. Even if you believe in shareholder primacy, even if you believe in profit being the main driver of your business, which I don't necessarily subscribe to, but assume you're in that, you automatically have to conclude now that the best way to continue to exist, to continue to be profitable, is to attack these challenges of people and planet if you want to. So if people ask me, are you an optimist or a pessimist, I've always felt that it's better to be an optimist, you have a happier life. I've also felt that going the pessimist route never leads to anywhere. So I call myself a prisoner of hope.
Así que yo soy un esclavo de la esperanza.
Drive to that higher level
y si todos podemos apuntar a ese mayor purpose-driven leadership,
I think we can all come out of this crisis significantly better than we went in. And that is the desire of 95% of the CEOs I talk to, 100% of the population. And I tend to believe also a safer and more stable environment for the politicians if we can get there. Well, I think my uplifting message is already on hope. One of my great friends in Argentina, amongst many friends I have, is Charlie Alberti, who was the great drummer of Soda Stereo, one of the bands that I grew up with. They had courage in a regime at that time that wasn't very easy to rally the people and gave them hope. But again, he stepped up in R21 with his organization. And anytime I see and talk to the young people in any of the universities I've been with you, or even the shows of Cirque du Soleil, playing their music and showing what is possible, and seeing everybody sing in unity, I know that you have this enormous force, that enormous optimism, that enormous desire to improve the lives for all of the people in any part of the world. Argentina cannot be successful if you only create small islands of prosperity in an ocean of poverty. Argentina cannot be successful if it doesn't produce the products that increasingly the world is going to demand. Argentina will not be successful if you exclude too many people. You have delivered a great pope. You have delivered our queen in the Netherlands, so we want to thank you for that. You have an influence well around beyond your country. But now is the time for all of us, for all of you, to step up and also show that collectively we can certainly get a better outcome than what we are currently seeing around us. So thank you for what you're doing, thank you for your courage, and thank you for being part of the solution and creating businesses that we can be proud of to have them around.
Thank you, Thank you for such an inspiring and insightful conversation.
And personally, I would like to recognize you, and I really admire what you have been doing to impact so many people's lives. So thank you so much. Now I would like to turn just a second to Spanish to tell something to the audience and un poco lo que les quiero compartir, como decía Paul, que esto no es su momento.
esto no debe ser un momento, esto es un movimiento positivo, y como decía Paula al inicio, es un movimiento hacia revertir la tendencia, hacia actuar, hacia capitalizar esta gran oportunidad que tenemos de generar un mundo sustentable, una sociedad sustentable, por todos nosotros y por nuestras futuras generaciones. Muchas gracias, thank you Paul again. And nice to see you, hoping to see you next time in Argentina, in person.
La próxima vez en persona.
Gracias, Florencia, y mucha suerte en el camino y hasta pronto. Un abrazo.
Gracias.